The problem is, of course, the humans.
No one would have believed in the first years of the 21st century that this world was being watched keenly and closely by intelligences greater than man's, and yet as mortal as his own, that as men busied themselves about their various concerns, they were scrutinized and studied, perhaps as narrowly as a man with a microscope might scrutinize the transient creatures that swarm and multiply in a drop of water. No one gave a thought to the older worlds of space as sources of human danger, or thought of them only to dismiss the idea of life upon them as impossible. Yet, across the gulf of space, intellects fast and cool with the unsympathetic regarded this Earth with envious eyes, and slowly and surely drew their plans against us.
Breaking news, today's headline, there has been a peculiar explosion coming from Mars. And over to Aisha, who has more detail.
It could have been a man-made source.
The chances of there being life on Mars are 1,000,000 to 1.
How could these explosions possibly be happening regularly? Could it be the Martians?
There's no life on Mars, I've already told you that.
There's more and more explosions every time. What are we going to do about it?
There's nothing we can do, it's 1,000,000 miles away.
The best thing to do about it is
to stay calm and don't panic.
What the hell is that thing?
There's something coming out of it.
Hey, look, it's one of those Martian things. Aren't those things really dangerous?
Big news. Aliens, catastrophe. Disaster. Is the world gonna end? We don't know. Over to Saba with some emails that you have just sent into our emails.
Okay, number one. Weird thing I've ever seen in my life from Stella, who's 10 years old from Oxford.
Reports flooding in from all over the country, every corner. Now I'm gonna pass it on to Ikra, which is in Stratford, right now!
What happened?
As you know, I was the only survivor from the aliens.
How did you survive?
Well, my dad came and rescued me when I was about to die.
What happened to your dad?
Really, my dad, when he came and rescued me.
The houses are falling. There's a lady with two babies on each hand. She's been persuaded by a boy called Oliver Simpson to throw her babies down as he could rescue her. Firemen have set up a trampoline for the lady to jump down. A boy has been rewarded by the police a certificate and has been congratulated. His father said he's the bravest son I've ever had. Back to the studio.
Breaking news, the Martians are invading Earth. They're calling it War of the Worlds. Where are they coming from? Now I'll hand it to Zubair, our science reporter.
Professor Zubair, do you know why is the Martians invading the Earth?
There are no Martians in Mars.
But I got all these news reports from everybody all around the country, as they're saying, oh, there's Martians invading the Earth.
It's a lie, there are no Martians on Mars.
So there you have it. There's no Martians invading the Earth.
Martians, where?
Be in mind.
And now I am going to interview a few citizens. Our first civilian is Gary. Gary, have you seen any Martians?
Yeah.
Where?
In the news.
We mean in real life.
Yeah.
Where?
When I looked up in the mirror.
Ha ha ha. Well, now we are going to have to ask you to leave or else we're going to call security.
No, because I was here before you.
Security, security.
Have you read the newspaper? Martians, Martians, Martians!
Could this be the end of the world? I will now pass it on to David Cameron. David, what would you like to say to these British citizens?
I am David Cameron. And before I go on to the subject that we're all going to die, I'd like to say that I'm going on a holiday to Hawaii.
I know how devastated you all must be after that horrific video. May God be with us all and give us a peaceful death. And we'll now move on to the weather.
Tomorrow the weather will be more meteors twice the size with some lightning. And scientists have proven that the aliens are coming from Mars. Thank you for listening.
And now over to, did you see aliens?
When you met the alien, how did you kind of react?
Well, I got at first, I thought that it's just kind because I didn't really think that aliens are me. And then in the end when he was trying to kill me, I just whacked him with my handbag and I just went away back to space.
The Martians at first came up to me, smiled at me and high-fived me. But 10 seconds later, they tried to shoot me. Luckily, I was prepared for the worst.
This is it. This is the end. Now you know what you're up against.
Red weed is taken all over the world and it is choking the forest and blocking up the rivers. So is it all bad? Now I will be passing you on to the terrible twins from Mars.
Welcome to the Red Weed Bakery Show. Today we'll be telling you all about red weed. Red weed is grown all over Earth. Let me show you an example. This doesn't matter as soon as it's very tasty.
Tip 1, stay in your house with the resources you need.
Tip 2, follow tip 1 and you should be safe.
The Martian machine is protected. If an atomic bomb goes on the Martian machine, therefore the force shield will go on and it will not affect them.
Love that red weed.
And then some weird looking machines come out of the sky and they zap my family.
Red weed, try some.
Red weed, buy some.
I will soon have my revenge on the Martian children will never exist.
Kill the aliens! Kill the aliens! Kill the aliens!
I miss my family.
That was emotional.
That's true.
Now for the weather. Oh no, the weatherman got zapped by a death ray.
It's faulty or is it walking?
Shoot, shoot, kill it, shoot, shoot, kill it.
Alpha squad, take aim!
Fire!
The Martians are dying.
Breaking news. The Martians are dead or dying. The reasons, germs and bacteria. The Martians. Dead. Slain after all man's devices had failed by the humblest things that God in his wisdom has put upon this earth. The toll of billion deaths man has brought his birthright of earth and it is his against all comers. It will still be his with where the Martians 10 times as mighty as they are. For neither do men live nor die in vain.
As the mystery unfolds and the story be told, aliens do live on this earth and they are known. Yeah. Artificial intelligence, nope. They're just common folk who seem to live by a different code. They're not bound to religion, colour and other creeds. The aliens are coming, I really hope you take heed. And this ain't just spitting, I'm trying to stay alive. But one question, how you kill something that's ready to die?
Crowd gathered.
Let's go. Everybody gather, huddle close. goods inside. Everyone that came to party is sober. United we stand and divided we fall. Cause you never know when we might have to brawl and fight. Everybody gather, huddle close inside. Everyone that came to party is sober. United we stand and divided we fall. Cause you never know when we might have to brawl and fight.
Yeah, heard what the song say, gather. Everybody stop trying to fight. Splatter each other. Take it as you will. Leave it as that. Listen to the guitar. Yeah. Zoob on the track. Satan it. Nice that. That's what I said.